Hey there, fellow chalking friends. It's Meek and Maria, your independent chalk couture designer. Hello, hello, hello. Give me 1 second, and I am going to try something new here today that I have never done before. I don't know if it's going to work. I don't think it is. Okay, so never mind. I'm giving up. Hey there, everybody. Welcome, 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 welcome. Hope you're all having a great Friday night. It is Fantastic Friday. I love Fantastic Friday. On Fantastic Friday, we do a transfer that has a lot of words to it, or is a font or something super cool with words, which, you know, okay, it's a stretch. I realize it's a stretch because pretty much every transfer has words, right? So I had to come up with some funny little name. Hey, Debbie. Hey, Aunt Josephine. Welcome to Friday Night Chalking. We're going to make a cute project tonight. It's one of my faves. I've been looking for it. Oh, I threw it on the floor. It's one of my favorites. I've been looking forward to making this for a little while. So if you can please share my video, it helps me greatly. I know I say that every night, but it does truly help me tremendously just by that simple hitting the share button. So I put some wax on our board before I got you guys came on, and I'm just buffing it off so that we can get ready here. I'm trying to do it holding it so that my table doesn't jiggle the whole time while I buff. So I am just taking the wax off. Wax on, oh, wax off. That's kind of how I feel today. But you put the wax on, you leave it on for a minute. You know, the longer the better, and then you just buff it off. You can leave it on overnight and then buff it off. Doesn't matter. So, you know, doesn't hurt it to do it. Hey, Carol. Hey, Virginia. Thank you, thank you, thank you all for sharing. So yesterday's Thankful Thursday, we did share the 10 times. So we will be giving our sign that we made last night away. So, we got to play a game in the Make and Maria VIP group. So, we will be giving that sign away. So, you will want to make sure you're in that group if you're not currently in that group, because then you have the opportunity to win. Okay, so if you are watching the replay, thank you, thank you, and welcome, replay watchers. I know majority of you actually watch the replay, so I don't always get a chance to talk to you. So, I wanted to say thank you so much for watching my videos and hitting that share button, even though you're doing the replay. Tonight's project, let's get you. See, I figured it out today. It took me a while, but I figured it out. Tonight's project is, don't judge each day by the harvest you reap, but by the seeds you plant. Robert Louis Stevenson said that. He sounds important. I don't know who he is. But it's a great saying, right? So we are going to put this. This is just one of my little square boards I like to use. We're going to put this in the middle of our board, but we are going 3D on Fantastic Friday today. And I had a piece of ribbon. Oh, that fell on the floor too. Wow, I was throwing everything on the floor. So what we're going to do, if I would stop banging the table, you would stop jiggling. I apologize. I've been trying to get better about that. Okay, so we're going to put the words on. Move this over so you can see more. Scoochie over as I again jiggle the table. We're going to put the words on. We're going to put a ribbon on the bottom, like so. And then I have another chalkboard piece, and we're going to put the shovel on the chalkboard piece and attach it down a little lower. So we're going 3D tonight. This is my big adventure for the day. Doing a little 3D. We'll see. I don't know if it'll work or not, but I really like the tools, but they don't fit. I mean, we could chalk. Just chalk it. We're going to play with it, and we're going to see how this goes. But that's my thought process in my head. And Virginia and all my fellow Wild Berry lovers, Wild Berry is coming out to play on this Friday night. Woohoo! Wild Berry is going to be going to be a star performer this evening. So, real quick, Chalk Couture 101. Chalk Couture is an amazing, amazing company. We sell silk screen adhesive transfers and Chalkology paste in ink and surfaces. All of the things that you need to create beautiful pieces of art for your home. Home decor, pillows, t-shirts, canvas bags, ceramics, glassware, stainless steel water bottles, stainless steel wine glasses. You can pretty much chalk or ink on any surface, but it is a reusable silkscreen transfer. So you can use it over and over and over again. So it gives you a lot of versatility and a lot of fun play with the things that you like to create. Virginia says, yippee, that wild berry's coming out to play. Hey, Jan, I love this transfer too, Jan. I just think it's very appropriate. It's very appropriate. So that's what Chalk Couture is. And if you are ever interested in checking out the amazingness of what's out there, you can go to www.chalkcouture.com/MakeAMaria and you can see all the products that I use right there. I very rarely use a retired transfer because I always want to use things that you can actually see and go out and purchase if you're interested in them. Every once in a while, I do a retired transfer on like Thankful Thursday because those are some of those are pretty sought after, and then you could have a piece made with one of those. But for the most part, I don't use retired stuff. I use almost all Chalk Couture products with the exception of my surfaces. Sometimes I like to mix it up a little bit and use other surfaces because you don't have to use a Chalk Couture surface. You can chalk on anything, pretty much. So the Chalk Couture surfaces are really, really nice quality and I really, really prefer them. But sometimes I like to do, like I love these square boards. I use these square boards often just because they're little square chalkboards and I like them. They're a nice size. Hey, Montina from California. Oh, and the baby mama is with us tonight. Hello, Cassidy. You're supposed to be sleeping, Cassidy, because I'm sure that baby is going to be up pretty soon. And Lisa, I don't know if I said hi, Lisa, yet. Hi, Lisa. Okay, so we are going to get to chalking. So this is a C-size transfer. So a C-size transfer is 18 by 12. Yes, 18 by 12. They are $24.99 in price, and this particular one has pieces to it. So you can cut them apart. So it has these lines for you to cut so that you know where to cut your transfer apart. So it gives you pieces that you can then use, because you can use a transfer the way it is designed, or you can take several different transfers and put them together. So this particular transfer is part of our, I want to say, what's the name of the collection? It is part of the Homegrown collection. The Homegrown collection has several different transfers that are designed to be interchangeable. So they have similar fonts, similar charm, similar attributes to them so that they work really, really well together. They're made to be interchangeable between transfers. So this is the Homegrown collection. So it's a lot of garden stuff, it's really pretty. In the new catalog, oh my gosh. Ladies, I am so stinking glad that we have overcome my nemesis of flower arranging. Because if you have not gone and looked, the flower ones that came out are mind-blowing. And now that I am an aficionado of flower arranging, we are going for it deep because there are some really, really, really pretty flower ones out there that I'm so excited. I cannot wait to order. I have been waiting patiently to order them. I've been trying to pace myself. I haven't ordered them yet, but today I was looking at them again and I'm like, oh my gosh, I need to place my order. Okay, so again, I'm digressing. So this is your silk screen transfer. It's sticky on the back and it has a silk screen inside of it. So that's what gives you the very clean, very crisp lines and designs with the Chalkology paste. When you take your transfer out, the very first thing you do, well, you cut it apart if it has pieces. If it doesn't have pieces, you don't have to do that step, obviously. Is you write the name of the transfer or back, or I've seen people number them 1, 2, 3, and then on the back do 1, 2, 3. However you need to remind yourself which piece goes on which backer. So obviously in this particular transfer, it's easy to know this is the big one. But these two are very similar in size, so you might want to write on the back garden fork and garden shovel, or shovel fork, or 1, 2. Whatever you need to remember, what goes. So I'm just going to write harvest because that is the actual name of this transfer. And then I am going to write fork. I'm sure there is a very official gardening term. Like this is probably, would this be a spade? A hand shovel? I don't know. I won't put spoon because it's not a spoon. But that's what I would probably garden with. So I'm just going to put shovel. Okay, and I'll put hand shovel just because I don't really know what it's called. But I'm sure there is a very technical name for it. And I apologize if I'm offending any of my gardening viewers because I really don't know gardening. It's one of those things that when I need to weed, I call my amazing sister, who is a ridiculously talented gardener, and I say to her, I send her pictures. Is this a weed? Is this real? Am I supposed to be pulling this or not? Okay, I'm looking for my fuzzing towel, because once you have your transfer out and you have cut it apart, the next thing you do is you fuzz your transfer. But I packed it up because I'm going away tomorrow to chalk. So it's packed up already. Okay, so I'm just going to grab a regular old towel, which is obviously, you can use a regular old towel. You don't need my beautiful fancy Chalk Couture one, but I love my beautiful fancy towel. And it's not even fancy, it's just a Chalk Couture towel. But, so fuzzing is a step that you do when you need to put a little bit of fuzz on the back of your sticky transfer. And you do that because it helps your transfer not have to work so hard when you're pulling it off. So it sticks, but it doesn't need to be as sticky as this transfer is going to be because it's brand new. Jan, I got my square boards at Target. These are very old. I've had them for a very long time. They do not sell them anymore. They were in the bullseye section at Target. They were $5 a piece a long time ago. And I think I bought 40 of them at the time. I drove to every single Target for weeks and bought all of them. I do have my old glasses on tonight, Verge, because it's really hard. There's a really bad glare with the other ones. And thank you for telling me a trowel. So it's either Verge says this fancy little guy right here is called a spade. And Debbie says it's called a trowel. Ooh, I got fancy gardening friends with me tonight. Woohoo! Okay, so what you do is you pull your backer off of your transfer. And you're really careful not to have the back stick to itself because, so see, here I'm going to show you. The transfer backer is shiny or it's dull. When you go to put it back on, you put it on the shiny side. That's how you store your transfer. Now, your transfer is super, super sticky. You do not want it to touch itself. If it touches itself, when you go to pull it apart, you'll put holes in your transfer. Which potentially, depending on where the holes land, will ruin your transfer. So you want to be super careful when you fuzz this. So you're going to flip it over onto your towel, and you're just going to pick up some lint. And picking up some lint simply makes it not quite as sticky. Oh, Verge says Debbie is right. It's called a trowel. All right, well, now I'm going to have to, it's not a hand shovel. Hand spoon, you know. No, Maria. Who knows what the heck this stuff is really called? Like, who the heck is? You ladies will know this. Who's Robert Louis Stevenson? I'm thinking he wrote some. Like, okay, let's come up with some ideas. Who could he be? I'm guessing. Let's make some guesses. Nobody Google it yet. Who do we think he is? He's a poet. Maybe he was a farmer. Maybe he was a pioneer and he went across the Wild West. An author? Let's see, who do we usually make signs of with quotes on them? He was probably somebody really important because we're making a sign that he, with a saying that he said. Okay, so my transfer is nice and fuzzed. So I'm going to place it on my board. Now, learn from Maria. Where is the top of your board? Make sure you always check before you spread out your transfer, the air out, that you're on the top. Always check, because I have truly chalked more surfaces upside down than I care to count. AKA hand shovel, Debbie, you're right. It's a trowel, AKA hand shovel. Oh, you know, it really is amazing that I have survived in life, isn't it? Okay, so I'm putting my transfer down. I do not measure. Many, many people measure. I'm just not, that's just not my personality. So I don't measure. I simply eyeball it and go from there. You are free to measure. Pull out your ruler, do whatever you need to do. So once you put your transfer down, the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to push the air out. Now, this particular transfer has lots of detail in those letters and lots of opportunities for air. So, like you can't see it, but when I look at my transfer, I can see the bubbles because I have not removed any air yet. Ooh, he's an author. A pirate book. Ooh. A pirate book. Wow. But apparently he was a farming pirate. A kidnapped pirate author. Ooh, this story's getting even better. Okay, so you push all your air out, you go from the middle, and you go out. A kidnapped pirate author. And I wonder where my kids get their imaginations from, right? I like to sit in the mall and look at people and just make up stories about them. I'm one of those. You know, sometimes we all just need that little escape. So, I am pushing. Okay, Lisa. Ooh, now we're talking pirate too. It's Friday night. Can't you ladies tell? It is Fantastic Friday. So, on Fantastic Friday, we can talk in errs and ars and Someday my children are going to watch these videos and they're going to be like, my mother was crazy. I own it. So these transfers, you can't see. You guys are too far. There we go. With this transfer, you got to get every single one of these. Oop, and I can see a piece of my fuzz is in my silk screen. You got to get those out. His book was kidnapped? How do you kidnap a book, Virginia? Let me, okay. I'm teasing you. So the book was named Kidnapped. Why would he be talking about harvesting and planting? Oh well, now I'm gonna have to read the book. Kidnapped by Robert Louis Stevenson. Okay, so again, I am really working this longer than I am what I do a normal transfer. Just because, again, when you look at all those little lines, you really want to make sure every single one of them is pressed down. Because this, the detail that we are going to get with this will be amazing. Absolutely, positively amazing. When you see this bad boy done. Okay, so I think I'm good. The other thing that you want to know is your transfer, the adhesive is pressure sensitive, so rubbing it helps it stick. Okay, I think we're good to go. So, can I move me? I'm going to try moving me. Let's try. Ooh! Look, I'm back. Okay, can I move? I go. No, it's not going to let me. All right, never mind. Sorry. Oh, it did let. Now, how did. Look! Hi, Mom! I'm way down in the corner. Oh, goodness, ladies. Sometimes you do have to wonder. This is when you say, hey, Maria, don't touch your stuff, Maria. Just leave it the way it was. Okay, now I... Ooh! Okay. You know, I hate it personally when I watch videos and the people are crazy like me. So I can only imagine what you guys think when you watch me. All right, well, we might just end up with me down, way down there. Let's get rid of this. Maybe you can watch the top of my head. There we go. Hi! Oh, goodness gracious. Isn't this funny? Okay, so he wrote a book called Kidnapped. He had others, too. I'm going to Google now because my brain hurts from trying to remember. Virginia, you don't have to try to remember. It's okay. Oh, okay, so I'm way down in this little tiny corner. So what I do is I use a program called Switcher Studio. And Switcher Studio is what allows me to... Ooh, no, I didn't want to do that. Allows me to use both the cameras. And as clearly I have demonstrated in the last 2 days, I don't have any idea how to use it. All right. Oh, now, okay, well, at least now I'm not way back down in the corner anymore. I don't know. I'll do this later. I apologize. It drives me crazy when I watch people and they're always like, oh, I don't like technology. Okay, sorry, anyway. All right, so we are playing with Wildberry and White. Hey, Sherry. Welcome to our chalking party. We are going to do some Wildberry and White. And I'm going to do Harvest and Plant in White. And then I want to do these little words in between in Wildberry. I think that's the route we're going to go. Treasure Island, Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, and A Children's Garden of Verses. Wow, he wrote a lot of books. He was super smart. And he talked about harvesting and planting and reaping what you sow, right? Okay, so I've got my white out. This particular one needs a drink, so we're gonna give him a little bit of a drink. And get it going. This is gonna be so, so pretty when we're done. I'm really excited about this one. So we got to 10 shares on Thankful Thursday's video. So we are going to play a game in the Making Maria VIP group. And I will post the game. And then everybody has a chance to win the sign we made last night. If you are not local, you just have to pay for shipping to you. If you are local, then we can work on arranging a getting it to you. So my chalks are not in too sad a shape, but they haven't been used in a bit. So I'm just giving them a little drink of water and stirring that water in. And that way they become a very nice yogurt sour cream consistency, and they will squeegee beautifully onto our project. This project, once I actually get chalk down, isn't going to take very long. So, I don't know why, but I tend to chalk sideways. Okay, so we're going to do white and white. Wildberry, 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 wildberry. And then I think we'll do these pretty little things in white too. That's my plan. And I'm sticking to it, I think. I think that's what we're going to do. So, now that I got myself back out of the corner, if you can please, please share my video. It helps me tremendously when you share the video. I'm going to start with Wildberry here. And I'm just going to go in between these lines. So I just put my chalk paste down and I push it through with my squeegee. Now, actually, this squeegee is too big. If I use my multi-purpose tool, I can go right down my line. Look at how this is... one of those examples of having the right tool makes the job much easier. Doesn't mean you can't do it the other way, because you totally can. It just makes it much easier when you have a skinnier squeegee. So I'm just putting on my Wildberry. I like the Wildberry with the black and white ribbon that we're going to use. And just black, the black board and the white paste, I think. The three color combination is one of my faves. as you all know, because I talk about Wildberry all the time. And we use Wildberry often. Although Red Raspberry really did come into, give it a run for its money in popularity. Okay, so now I'm going to go to Small Squeegee and move to White. And I'll probably use a combination of the Small Squeegee and my chalk is really drying fast tonight, and I'm thinking it's because there's something in my ear down here today. Or I didn't put enough water in. But it is totally drying super fast. Did it last night too. So I'm putting my chalk on. Could be because I'm too busy yapping and I'm not paying enough attention to what I'm doing. So then it doesn't go as easily for me because I'm not paying attention. So you want to be careful. So see how I got some of my wild berry in there? I just want to make sure I get that off of my squeegee, A, before I put it back in my container. And B, I will inadvertently smoosh it through my white, and I don't want to do that. So I don't want to contaminate my color, and I don't want to contaminate my silk screens. So we are just squeegeeing away. This is a gorgeous transfer. Oh, I'm so excited too. I've been working on our Monday Whip It Up, our Make It Monday project. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited about it. I don't know why I'm so excited about it. Maybe because I actually drilled holes myself. You know, shocking. As I was doing it, because my kids are off of school, they came in. I was in my husband's tool room. You know, that was the first sign, right? I was somewhere I wasn't supposed to be. So my kids walk in and they're like, oh, Mom, are you supposed to be in here? Mom, do you know what you're doing? I said to him, I said, you know what, y'all, I did survive before your father. I did really know how to use these things. And truly, it was just the little, you know, the drill press. It wasn't like I was using the table saw. I let him do the table saw. And I did totally do it just because he wasn't home and I could do it. Because he wasn't here to yell at me about not doing it. Okay, so my chalk is drying. So I am going to pull very... Ooh, I don't have my water bath in here. So when you pull your transfer off, you start it in the corner just to help you get it up. And then you pull from the middle. Oh, goodness. This is gorgeous. Oh, my, 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 my. Okay, I'm going to hold it up so you can see it. But in person, wow. Wow, 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 wow. I love this transfer. I'm going to dry it quick so I don't stick my finger in it. Plus, drying it, then the wild berry will pop more. Because you can't see the wild berry as easily as I can. The wild berry looks amazing! As it always does, right? Wild berry always looks good. So because there's a lot of silkscreen to this transfer, that's why it takes just a minute more to dry. A lot of silkscreen, so it uses a lot of paste. Oh my goodness, this is gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So can you see how that wild berry is starting to pop more because it's drying? Okay. I'm going to hold it up for you to see. So check it out. You see the wild berry? Look at the detail. So see, I got a little bit of that. That's where I pull in the color. That doesn't bother me. Some people it bothers. Okay, so here's our beautiful beginning. And look, by the time I started putting chalk down, this didn't take us very long. Yeah, look at how cute that is. Oh my goodness. Okay, so now what I want to do is I'm going to take our sign and set it aside for a minute because I want to chalk our, what did we decide this is called? A trowel? Did we decide it's a trowel or a hand shovel? I gotta go back. We decided that this is called a trowel. Okay, we're going to chalk our trowel on this little tiny chalkboard. And we're going to fuzz it again on my towel. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty. So I take my transfer off on my backer, and I do not do it the way I just did it. Lay it down and take the backer off of the transfer. Sometimes, you know, this is like my kids. Don't do it the way I do it. Do it the right way. So I'm just giving a little bit of fuzz to the back of my transfer so it's not quite as sticky. And then we're gonna stick this trowel on this super cute little board. And he's very close to fitting exactly on here. So I do want to make sure he's centered. And again, look at the detail that we're going to get on our trowel. Okay, so I got to go up and down to get all that air out. Okay, now we could do the handle in Wild Berry, but I don't know that many handles that are Wild Berry. So I was going to do them all in white, because then what we're going to do with them is we're going to stick them here on our board. I did think about doing one on each side, but I only had one of these pieces and I didn't want to pull out the table saw. But I think it would be really cute with the trowel and the fork. I might have to make my husband cut another board. I like it better this way. Or we can go back to, this was my original idea, was to just stick it, I don't mind that either. All right, well, let's chalk this guy. We're just gonna make him white, I think. Or should we make his, I mean, we could totally go crazy. I mean, we could do storm and white, we could do all storm. This and brown, but I kinda like the black, the white, and the wild berry. I think we're gonna go white. Just keep it simple. Simple, simple. Okay, so I'm grabbing my squeegee that I had my white on before. Just dipping and going. So you squeegee straight up and down. You don't squeegee flat. You squeegee straight up and down. That's what gives you the clean removal of chalk. Otherwise, you end up with very thick chalk. And that's okay. It's not a bad thing. You can get a lot of chalk off when you squeegee it straight up and down or at a good squeegee angle. Get a lot of chalk off, and then you're not wasting it. Ooh, Verge says handle Wild Berry. We're going to check it out, Verge, because of the delay. But if we don't like it, we're going to wash it off and make the handle Wild Berry. But Virginia, I really do think you'd make everything Wild Berry. You're like me, with the love of Wild Berry. Okay, so I'm wiping my squeegee off. Much easier to wipe things off when they are wet. Oop, and I'm paying no attention. Hello, don't you want to kick me and say, dummy, you didn't pull the transfer off yet. It's drying on you. Okay, so I pull my transfer again from the middle. And I pull it straight up and down. I don't pull it like this. Go straight up and down. Do the shovel part gray or silver. Silver and a brown tone for the shovel. Oh, I hate that silly delay on Facebook. Okay, so this is it in all white, which is still super cute. Super cute. We could wash it off and change it. Well, I'm going to quick clean up my squeegees here. We're going to put it down and see what it looks like. We could totally... Although, I forgot my water bucket today, so I can't wash off transfers that easily. Alright, so, let's pull this bad boy up here. Let's get rid of that so you can see what I'm doing. So what my thinking was this. And here, I'm going to hot glue it down. Here. And, you know, the gaps and stuff won't be there when I do it. Because it'll be tightly put on there. And then this. Well, this would need to come up a little bit. Or we could just chalk this on the board. But this was where I was going with it. When I thought the project out. It's just something a little bit like this. What do you think? Should we just chalk the shovel on the board? Or stick with my whole attempt to be 3D? Or we could wait and I could have my husband cut out another. I have the board for the other one. It's just too long. We could do this. And then do this guy on here. I'm not a big fan of the pitchfork. Because that's what that looks like to me, is a pitchfork. We could also chalk him right down here, because he would fit chalked down here. It'd be a tight fit, though. You guys aren't quiet. You're not voting. Okay, so I'm going to stick with... Boy, I got stuff thrown all over here today. I'm going to put my covers on my chalks for a minute. Clean up here just a second. And plug in my hot glue gun. So that we can do the ribbon, if that's the route we end up going. So hot glue gun is plugged in. Paster put away. Chalk on my board. I could leave it as is. You are right. I did do it up a little higher though, so it's not completely centered. I don't need the ribbon. I could just put it on without the ribbon. Two. I am completely and totally addicted to black and white ribbon. It's really a problem, really, at the end of the day. It's one of those addiction problems that I have. Like hoarding chalkboards. As I was at Target again today. Oh, did you guys see? Bullseye section. Buy 3, get 1 free. In case you were wondering. Bullseye section today was buy 3, get 1 free. I don't know if it's going to be that way tomorrow. I've never seen that before. So, I might have done a little chalkboard hoarding today at the old... Okay, I like it that way. I think that's the right route. Full disclosure, I am addicted to this ribbon. And we could do a ribbon on the top and the bottom. I have a lot of this ribbon. Ooh, that's cute too. We could do top and bottom. And then our little shovel. Yeah, that's too much. Right? That's too much. So we either need just that... or that on our, it's not a hand shovel, it's a trowel. Maria's learning her gardening tools. Okay, we're going with my original plan, unless somebody else has a burning desire to vote. Okay, so I'm going to, okay, Jan says that's cute. Now Jan, which one? We had a few options, Jan. I'm actually going to use this ribbon and not that ribbon because this ribbon already has the little kites on the bottom because I used that as a bow and did not end up liking it on my project. Do you ever do that where you get it all done, you get it all ready, the ribbon's cut, and then you're like, uh-uh, not doing that. All right, so I'm going to make sure again that I have it lined up where I want it because the hot glue gun is coming out to play. So it is where I want it. I am going to put my lovely little things I got from Bobby on my fingers so that I don't burn my fingers off like I always do. One of these is supposed to be a thumb, but oh well. I don't think we're quite hot enough yet. Oh yeah, we are. So I'm just putting a line of hot glue on my project. I'm gonna pull my ribbon and set it on. Virginia likes the original thought. Tie a fun little bow and put in the corner of the top. Oh, that would be cute too. We could try that. All right, so I'm just What's nice about these little funny finger guys is I can touch it and not burn my finger off. Okay, so I've got it started. They're hard to work with though when you're like manipulating things, so I typically only use it when I'm going to actually touch it. All right, so now I'm gonna pull this super tight taunt. I'm going to be very taunt with it. Get it as taunt as I can. And then I'm going to put my little finger guys back on quick. Grab my hot glue gun. Give myself another little line of glue. I'm actually gonna put two lines just to be safe because I'm gonna pull tight. As tight as I can get it. And then I'm just gonna get it down in that hot glue. And actually it's not super, it's not burning me today. So I got that down. Take my little finger guys off, cut my excess ribbon off. Like so. Love this ribbon, absolutely love this ribbon. Okay, so now we have this really cute little ribbon guy. And he's a little crooked. But he's movable. Wouldn't be a Making Maria original, right? If it was completely straight, you'd all wonder what the heck was wrong with me. Okay, so now we're just gonna stick him on. Now, I'm going to do something that I never ever do. I'm gonna actually measure. Try to make sure he's in the middle. So it's a 16-inch board. Let's start with where's the middle of this. This is a 10-incher. So this part right here. Here's my middle. Wow. This is why I don't measure. And I eyeball things. I am pretty darn close to being straight. Huh! Look at that, ladies. I've been redeemed. Okay, so. Now, these boards, this is an angle. It actually comes to a peak. So, I'm going to hot glue it down, but I'm probably going to need to put something behind it just to keep it secure. Because it'd be pretty easy to knock it off. So I'm going to put my glue down. I need to think about that. You really only need it in the middle. You can't see what I'm doing. I'm just doing little line of glue down the middle of my board. Oh, sure, now I moved it, and here I had measured. I gotta re-measure. Don't you just wonder about me? Okay, so that was my middle. And I'm going to stick it down. I'm gonna hold it, because we don't want to have the same debacle that we had the time I hot glued the flowers on, I lifted it up, and then my flowers fell off. I'm going to have to see how, I'm going to have to put something behind it. So I will use a piece of wood, a shim type, and hot glue it behind it. But this way you can see the general idea of what I am going for here. So this is our cute little sign. I am in love with this sign. Okay, so right now he's really just hot glued to the ribbon. So I'm going to put, I have all kinds of pieces of wood everywhere. I'm going to put a wood shim behind it so that it sits up. So this is our cute little project. Don't judge each day by the harvest you reap, but by the seeds you plant. Robert Louis Stevenson. And again, we are an educational chalking show. We are not just chalking. We have yet, now we've talked about pirates. We've talked like pirates. We've learned the names of garden tools. Ladies, this is so much more than just chalk. I am crazy. All right, so let's go here. Get me out of there, and you can totally see. I gotta wash my board off. Don't pay any attention to that. But this is our super cute. The board is 16 by 16. The actual chalkboard is 14 by 14. And then let's go here. And this is what it's gonna look like. Yep, hung up on a wall with a little shim behind it. Yeah, I'm gonna need the shim because now it leans forward when I hold it up. So I'm gonna stick a little something behind it just to give it some extra support. And look, Mom, I chucked on the top. I don't have to wash it off or move the hangers. So this is our super cute little project. This is, the transfer's called Harvest. It's a C-size transfer. You can find it at www.chalkcouture.com/MakeAndMaria. And you can find all the products that I use there. If you are curious at all about what the heck it means to be a Chalk Couture designer and you're looking for information about it, I'm more than happy to kind of fill you in on the ins and outs and how it works and how you can make money paying for your hobby and having lots and lots of fun with it and meeting tons of amazingly wonderful people. We are giving away last night's project, which was Dreams. As I break my place, Dreams don't work unless you do. We're doing this in the Making Maria VIP group. So if you're not currently in that group, you need to get in that group and you can comment, add me, or you can go right to Making Maria VIP group and click on the request to join, which is what most of you do. But either way, I can get you in there. And last but not least, my last tiny little commercial is the new Club Couture will be coming. I have not gotten a sneak peek at all about what next month's Club Couture is going to look like. A Club Couture is a monthly subscription service where once a month, like magic, for $19.99 a month, the little project arrives in the mail. And you get a B-size transfer and 3 paste packets. These are what paste packets look like. You get 3 different colors every month. They're always a color. They're never white. But you get 3 paste packets and a B-size transfer. And it gives you kind of that, just that guaranteed knowing of, hey, I get a little me time this month. And even if it's 15 minutes of, I get to make myself a project. Sometimes they're whimsical, sometimes they're home decor, sometimes they're gifts, they're seasonal. They're all different every month, and it's a surprise. We never know which one we're going to get. So it's always super fun to get that envelope in the mail and go to the mailbox and find it. So it's super, super fun. So if you're interested in Club Couture, you can comment Club, and I'd be more than happy to send you a link on checking out what that means and what that's worth and all that good stuff. So, thank you so much for watching me. I am Making Maria, your independent Chalk Couture designer. Please, please, please share my video. It helps me tremendously when you do that, and I thank you and appreciate it every time you do that. But tomorrow, this is a little bit of a crazy weekend because it's a holiday, and my poor children don't want to go to church anymore. Poor things. I'm drawing them every day. It's okay. It's good for them. So we will not have a video on Sunday night, most likely. We might sneak one in, but you know, are you really going to want to watch me on Sunday? You're probably going to want to spend time with your family. So if I make one on Sunday, it'll just be a bonus something. Otherwise, Monday, I cannot wait for Monday. Monday's Make It Monday. And Monday's project is always a nice little project to get you started and get you the product in your hands so that you can play with it. And I'm so excited about this one because I actually used the drill press and drilled those holes myself. So proud of myself. It's a drill press, really, Maria. I know, but I was proud of myself. So Make It Monday's project is a really cute little project. So that's coming up on Monday. Target Tuesday. Okay, I'm rambling. Never mind. I can give you all this next week. Say goodnight, ladies. Have a wonderful Friday night. Good weekend. Enjoy your Easter and your time with your family. Thank you so much for watching me. Have a lovely, lovely evening. If you're watching the replay, please hit share. And if you're watching me on my YouTube channel, subscribe to my channel so that you can see this. We do this every day, except for the weekends. Thanks. Bye.